Hey everyone, my name is Anton Telitsyn. I'm a CEO of Active Game Studio, which is a developer of game Lordmaster 2. I will tell you about our experience of building an MMORPG being an indie studio, and I will tell you also about some risks and potential of using cryptocurrency inside the game. But first I will shortly tell you the whole story of Lordmaster. In general, Lordmaster, it's an MMORPG where users can use cryptocurrency for in-game trading on an open game market. So it's a game with an open game world, open game market, synchronous PvPs, clans, and etc. The story began in 2006 when we decided to develop an MMORPG game for Java cell phones. You must remember those phones and games presented on them. The majority was just simple action or puzzle games, but we did a multiplayer game, 100 kilobytes for Java applet, pixel graphics, slow edge internet, but everything worked and even working now. In 2014, we realized that the game is still active and even profitable. You know that for any MMORPG, the strongest motivation for players are social activities. Of course, we had clans, we had castles, castle sieges, but also we had an open game market. There are some screenshots from our official community. People there are trying to find opportunities to buy or sell some specific items. And I think you know that real money trading in game industry has a long history and has been historically banned by most Western game developers and publishers, especially in case of MMORPGs. But nevertheless, MMORPGs are also the games in which real money trading and open market are in highest demand by users. And our experience from Lordmaster 1 proved the same. So we started building its improved version, Lordmaster 2. In 2015, we had the very first prototype. It consisted only just a set of battles, no PvP, no multiplayer. And we started visiting game conferences, trying to establish partnerships with publishers and investors. But nobody wanted to invest in a prototype, so we continued our developing. And next year, our game was selected to a global top round. It's a game accelerator. We took part in the accelerating program and received some money as investments. But you can easily imagine that 40,000 for MMORPG is almost nothing. Funds got over just in several months. And then in 2017, seeing all these ICOs, suddenly we realized that Lordmaster has a great potential of using cryptocurrency. We decided to combine our experience of using open game markets and a blockchain technology and create a blockchain-based open market in the game. It was quite a quick decision, and just in 2 months we conducted pre-ICO, and then in last December we conducted ICO, raised almost $1 million. And it's enough to complete the development, and now the game is in soft launch in Russia. We see quite good results, and I think just in a few weeks the game will be launched globally. So now let's speak about the most important lessons learned building Lordmaster 2. Funding. I think it's the most crucial question for each indie developer. Searching funding wasn't easy at all for us. When we started our work, we had some funds from private investors, and we were hoping to get money from publishers once we had a working prototype. But when we had a prototype, they said, oh, nice work, guys, keep going and return to us once you have an almost completed game. When we had an almost completed game, the same people said, oh, good progress, nice work, guys, keep going and return to us when you have some good metrics from your soft launch. So it was our big mistake. If you need money, you need to try to find some sources that fit your current project status. Private investors, accelerators, crowdfunding, ICO, and you need to reach publishers only when you have some metrics from your soft launch. From the very beginning of the development, each developer should consider, should think hard about the set of necessary mechanics to be implemented. The majority of indie developers are working on casual or hyper-casual games, and in general they are right, but we have been working on a MMORPG, and you can imagine that any MMORPG consists of too many game mechanics. Battle, hero, development system, equipment, castles, magic spells, I don't know, crafting, enhancement, and etc. And if we could start from the very beginning, I think we would remove some features like open game world and focus more on core game loop and goals for players. Probably it could make our path shorter. When we started developing Lord Mancer 2, we thought that our existing user community from Lord Mancer 1 would be a good start, would be good early adopters for Lord Mancer 2. And when we had a demo version, we started collecting their feedback and implementing features as requested. But after a while, we realized that these players were not interested in getting a new game. They just wanted to get their Lord Mancer 1 back, probably with improved graphics, but that's all. For example, the most common request was to add two more races that had been existed in Lord Mancer 1. That's all. So user feedback is a matter, but only the developer has the entire vision of the game, and only the developer should make final decisions, even if these decisions are not fitting for a part of the community. Blockchain. You know that the most of blockchain-based games can be hardly called games. They usually based only on one collectible mechanics, and there are some reasons for this. Each blockchain has some restrictions, low transactions, each transaction should be caused by someone, should be paid by someone, and also there are no random events inside the blockchain. So, for example, if you're trying to create a battler, it means that the result of any battle is known just before the battle itself. It looks boring, and in fact it is boring. So if you're trying to extend user experience with different mechanics, you need to either create your own blockchain with zero cost fast transactions, or you need to run some code outside the blockchain. We had the same choice, and we decided to focus on the game itself instead of blockchain. So we are using blockchain only to create our own cryptocurrency Lordcoin and to store some rare items inside the blockchain. Using cryptocurrency and blockchain has some advantages, of course, but also there are some risks. In general, stores are not happy about using cryptocurrency. For example, Google and Apple prohibit using non-in-app purchases as the main method of payments. Apple prohibits in-game trading between players in case of in-app purchases. And Google and Apple has some specific rules, regulations for crypto-related applications like wallet or exchanges. So as a solution, we have divided, we have separated the game and all Lordcoin operations. So you can just download a game and start playing without any blockchain wallet or something else. And only if you want to use cryptocurrency or you want to tokenize any item, you need to connect a blockchain wallet to the game, and then you will be able to use cryptocurrency, but not in the game, but on an external website. You know that during all gold rushes, the most of miners didn't get rich. Even if they earned some money, they spent all their money on food, entertainment, or some services. And if you're speaking about cryptocurrency and gaming industry, they look like gold rushes of our days. And there are too many services around that demand your money. Advisors, lawyers, advertising, I don't know what else, crypto exchanges, wallets, and you need to be very effective in spending money. Even if you think that you have enough money, you need to be effective. Developing a game is like developing any other startup. No matter what you're doing, a game, a travel service, or a banking service, you need to create a product that fit its users. So you need to learn such words as lean startup, cost dev. You need to make some small changes. You need to measure the meanings. And finally, we managed to do game releases each week, even if we make only a couple of small changes. We release it, and it allows us to measure the meaning of these changes. And it's the first slide. It's the last slide of my presentation. You know that any in-game items can be valuable only if the game has its own user base. If user base is vast, it means that there will be a demand on in-game items. So players don't care about technologies, about blockchain, etc., but they do care about gameplay and about the game itself. So products should be the first. And it's our goal to make an exciting game, and there will be no matter what technologies and blockchain and coins are used. So that's all. Thank you.
Okay, do you have any questions for Anton? You go for it. I've got some as well.
Hi, thanks for the speech again. I was wondering, did you consider making the game without the blockchain? Mm-hmm. When did you decide to take it, like definitely choose that you will have the blockchain and the in-game trading with your own coin?
Yeah, sure. From the very beginning, we didn't use blockchain inside the game. As I said, the story began in 2014 when we started developing Lordmancer 2. But there were two main reasons to use blockchain. The first one is to have some advantages, some specific feature inside the game to compete with other players. And the second one is just funding. Yeah, as I said, it wasn't easy to find funds to complete the game, especially in case of MMORPG. It's a lot of work.
Have you already said to the player base that the game is going to be released on this or this point? Or have you decided or tried the publishers at this point? Like if you would get funding and dropping the blockchain and maybe even paying back the ICO funders?
We are not going to pay back ICO founders as it will. We didn't sell our token as security token, so we can't. Yeah.
The question was, could you now go to publishers with the game and get it published normally?
Yeah, we are trying to reach publishers now, but yeah, there are some other risks, you know, that big publishers are not ready to work with blockchain-based games. Yeah, some of them are looking into this industry, and you can see them on this event or other events, but they are not ready. But also there are some probably not big publishers, but there may be a possibility to find a publisher.
So, as I understand, the majority of your players are off-chain, yeah. Right? So can you share any details, how many of these players actually convert to blockchain players, and how do you convince them to make that move, go to your website and purchase the currency?
For now, it's not many. I think that probably 1% or something like that. But you know that it's a free-to-play game, and in any free-to-play game, only probably 5% is paying users. So, and our game has both monetization model, in-app purchases and this blockchain part. So if 5% will pay with fiat money and 1% will pay with cryptocurrency, it's okay for us.
And just to confirm, you're a mobile game?
Yeah, it's a mobile game.
So you'll be going live on App Store and Google Play?
Yeah,
kind of simultaneously.
Sure.
Yeah. And when was that again?
I think we will launch on Google Play this month, and and on Apple it will be later, but this year.
Cool. I was about to ask about the same question. So you have a mobile game where you have a dual payment system. One is in-app purchase inside the game, and you have then people who acquire token during the ICO who can now spend it externally of it, right? And
people,
did one cannibalize the other, so it's really complementary revenue?
I don't think it will cannibalize each others. As I said, there are different players. Some of them are familiar with cryptocurrency, some of them are not. And we have classical in-app purchases for classical monetization, like a premium account or some boosts in-game and so on. And cryptocurrency usage is mostly about in-game trading between players.
Did you try some kind of A/B testing where you actually left players choose, I want to pay all services, subscription, totally in token, or I want to go the usual route, to see how far the one who holds token can go into spending in your game?
No, we didn't.
That would be an interesting experiment, I think.
Probably. We'll try.
Cool. And in terms of your wallet, is that you basically created your own wallet app alongside not using it?
No, we are not going to create our own wallet. We are going to establish a partnership with one of the platforms.